Hi, I'm Richard Greene, president of the Keystone Project, and I have just a brief testimony that I'd like to share with you. You know, we read in Matthew chapter 9, beginning in verse 36, that as Jesus was moving about, that seeing the people, he felt compassion for them because they were distressed and dispirited like sheep without a shepherd. And then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Therefore, pray to the Lord of the harvest to send out workers into the harvest." Some years ago, I was in Ethiopia, and we were traveling along the a ridge in the mountains extending from Addis Ababa to the Djibouti border. And as we were traveling on this mountain ridge, we were passing through villages. And it was amazing to see the conditions of the people. We would enter a village and they would all be gathered together in the market, in the main square of the village. And as we were passing through one of the villages, a little boy ran out in front of our vehicle and he was struck by the vehicle and his leg was hurt. And blessedly, it wasn't severely hurt, but we took the boy and his mother some miles further into the next city where there was medical treatment, because in their village, there was no medical treatment. And I remember sitting in the back of the vehicle with this mother and this young boy. And I noticed that they were just covered with flies. I don't mean that there were a few, but they literally seemed to have dozens and dozens and dozens of flies that were on them and flying about them. And it was the world that they lived in. They didn't seem to notice these flies. They didn't brush them away. It just seemed normal to them. Whereas for me, looking at this scene was really quite moving, because I realized the effect of the curse. And it was like I was seeing something in the spirit of the curse that was upon so many of the lost peoples of the world, and how the curse became normal to them. They knew no other way. And so, brothers and sisters, with the gospel of the kingdom, we have a curse-breaking hope to bring to people. And they may think that the curse is normal, that their addictions are just a normal part of life, that their sin is just the status quo, and that is the way that it's going to be forever. But we need to penetrate that mindset with the gospel so that they can see the hope that they can have in Christ and be delivered from the weight, the heaviness, the power of the curse. This is the call of God upon us as we go and make disciples of all the nations, lifting the curse off of the lives of those who are even unaware that the curse has ruled them for so long. May God give you a heart to recognize and see these things in the spirit. May he give you the voice and the compassion that Christ had. May you see the multitudes the way that he saw them, so that you and I can make a difference in this world. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.